Greetings everyone, this is a presentation of my latest project that I've just completed. It's a Millennium Falcon coffee table. It's a project that I started about 2 years ago, basically motivated by the fact that I purchased this Hasbro Falcon probably back in 2009 or 2010. And I wanted to display it in the home cinema room, and unfortunately I didn't have the proper space to do that. So initially it was displayed on the wall, but it wasn't looking very good. So I decided to find another solution, and I looked for a table made of teak. And I decided to use it as a display case. So I modified it a little bit and I created side panels to put a little bit of decoration, sci-fi decoration all around. And those panels actually are also lit up, as you can see over there. I'm going to flip the switches afterwards so that you can see, but those panels have electroluminescent panels behind, and they light up. So basically the Falcon has been fully rewired and has a couple of new options. It has new landing lights, landing gear lights, position lights, front lights. All of this has been redone and rewired and hooked up to a microcontroller board. And there is also an infrared receiver that is in the top post over there that can receive the orders from my home cinema main remote. So I don't need an extra remote to do this. And using the remote, I can still operate all the different switches that were on the toy Falcon. So you had a bunch of switches over there. Three switches there. You had the radar that you could operate using, I forgot where it is. There is a slider, I think the slider is over there at that corner. And when you move this, it moves the radar and it will trigger some sounds. So all this interaction is actually preserved. And basically by pressing on those buttons that I don't use on my home cinema system, or at least I don't point the remote in the direction of the amplifier, I just point it here and it will trigger some action. So I have the fake start, the cold start of the Falcon that eventually will start properly. So it's all encased into the box, so you have a limited sound, but you can still enjoy the sounds. It's shy, but at least it's completely covered and dust-free. So it stops automatically after a while. The engines have been remade using NeoPixel type of LED strip. So you can start the engine again. Progressively, you have the light speed burst. And in this current mode, each time it's doing an action, it's changing the light up all around. So I'm going to do that again. It's moving to another color. I'm going to trigger some quotes. And it's going through the colors.
Not wise of Sir Wookie.
I suggest a new strategy, R2. Let the Wookie win.
So additionally, if I flip, I think this is this switch, I go into another mode and I can operate those switches, play, stop, pose and so on, and I can manually browse through the colors if I want to select a particular ambience for the table. Like this, can go back and forth choosing a specific color. And I can also pose using the pose button, the interaction. I hope it's going to work. But yes, in this case, I stop the color changing operation each time I'm triggering something. So I can stay on that nice color here. And I still have the same lighting ambience.
With the blast shield down, I can't even see. How am I supposed to fight?
And I can reactivate, hopefully.
You've taken your first step into a larger world.
And so on. And you can select your ambience.
With the blast shield down, I can't even see.
You have the whole sequence with R2 and the Wookiee playing the game.
I suggest a new strategy, R2. Let the Wookiee win.
And so finally I can show how to operate the main switches. I have the power supply that is going under here. And I have three switches that I can control and flip to turn everything off. I can leave only the side panels so that you enjoy the Death Star look of the walls and you can still see the Falcon a little bit. Of course, as the room is turned in the dark, looks even better. Then I can flip the main lighting with the LED strips. I can stop the Falcon or start it again and have it all in the dark, or just having the LED strip, or put basically everything back.
With the blast shield down, I can't even see. How am I supposed to fight?
So this is it. This is my Millennium Falcon coffee table, and it's going to be a great addition to the movie room, so that we can have dinner and appetizers over there watching a movie with the Falcon. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Bye.